Good evening. After months locked in by our borders, our state has taken two big steps towards freedom. South Australia announcing it will welcome all visitors from New South Wales from Thursday, while Queensland will expand its border bubble. It comes following zero cases of community transmission here today.
After fighting a border battle on two fronts, today, ceasefires.
We have been closely looking at the border zones between Queensland and New South Wales.
From the 1st of October, the first border back down. Residents of five northern New South Wales shires now included in a growing border bubble.
They will be able to freely travel around Queensland, and Queenslanders will also be able to travel there as well.
It creates a border buffer zone where people from anywhere in either state can travel, meet and holiday together and be able to return home without the need for quarantine.
I'm not too sure logic has been at the forefront of the decisions to put the wall up or to take it down.
There is so much inconsistency with this, and the decisions aren't being made based on health grounds.
I do feel it's appropriate this time for the Queensland Government to consider bringing down the whole border.
Like South Australia, opening entirely, opening sooner, and opening in time for Blues fans hoping to travel for Origin 1.
We've still got a long way to go, but I think this common sense move today, we look forward to seeing more of that.
As of Thursday, we will be opening the border with New South Wales that's subject to no community transmission occurring in New South Wales between now and midnight.
There were no community-acquired cases at all. For the first time in 2 months, the only cases in the state were inside hotel quarantine.
However, obviously we want to see the testing rates go up.
There were just 7,500 tests reported in the last 24 hours. The government ruling out random testing, but also keen to see fewer empty testing sites like this one. As for Queensland, the wait continues. Officials say their next border announcement won't come until the end of October. Charles Croucher, Nine News.
And Nine's Mark Burrows is at Sydney Airport this evening. Mark, airlines are scrambling to put on extra interstate flights.
Peter, welcome to the ghost town that is Terminal 2 Sydney Airport, but maybe that is about to change. Virgin is boosting its Sydney to Adelaide run to a daily service now, and it's recommencing flights between Canberra to Adelaide and Brisbane. From Thursday, Qantas will start flying again between Sydney and Adelaide. The airline stopped flying the route back in July. Jetstar is ramping up Sydney to Adelaide flights to twice daily. All eyes, though, are still on Queensland. When will it open up to Sydney? So today's announcement is not a rush to all destinations, but Peter, at least it's a start.
It is. Thank you, Mark.